Again, skipping a couple of chapters because there's a Twilight romance fic I really want to get to. Okay, just making sure, it's just a Twilight romance story, right? It was a good partner, right? Yeah, Trix, nobody else. There's nobody else Twilight is partnered with that would scare you. Oh, is he partnered with Starlight in that fic? Yes, he's totally partnered with Starlight. Sylvie. Trixie, guess it's kind of not expected that Starlight, being as powerful as she is, would be partnered with Twilight in some of these stories. Oh well. Trixie can handle that. Yeah. Don't tell her, guys. I really don't want my boss to know that she's going to be paired with Twilight. You know how Trixie gets when there's Twixie involved. She'll go crazy. So, continuing on. By the way, skip me some more, because I just fick. Fidel finds out that she had a hysterectomy, can't have any more kids. Oh no. And then Gohan proceeds to have a dream where he starts thinking about what has happened. Don't talk like that. It's not as if this is your fault. Fidel shook her head. I should never have met with your father in East City. If I hadn't, maybe everything would have been alright. In truth, Gohan was starting to see his father's role in this. What role? They just had a meeting. That was it. What was he supposed to do? Go, no, I'm afraid your husband said no. Gohan, that doesn't make you a protector. That makes you controlling. Had Goku stayed away from his family, none of this would have been happening. He knew Fidel was trying to help. He knew he wasn't innocent himself. Yeah, you asshole. He'd been honest with her from the beginning. It's possible she never would have gotten out of her way and tried to restore the father-son relationship. How can you be so sure? What makes you so sure that would have made her want to do it more? You can't control her. Oh god, you want to control her, don't you? That's what this is. You're mad that she did something on her own. You possessive asshole. At the same time, he didn't want to upset her. He felt his past was his burden to bear. And that was at least until all this. Asshole! You're a freaking ass! Damn it! He cursed himself as a voice surrounded him. Why did everything have to turn out this way? It was like fate was against him. Had he told her the truth about his father from the beginning, she would have had to share the burden of his past with him. Oh, boo-hoo-hoo! You sexist ass! What? It's because she's a woman, isn't it? It's because she's a woman and she shouldn't bear the burden. She's also a martial artist and your wife. A marriage is a goddamn partnership! Which means, Gohan, you need to be willing to help her and she's willing to be helping you. You two supposed to talk and communicate with each other, not... I need to protect her from this horrible burden. Fuck you up your sexist ass, Gohan! Oh wait, of course you're sexist. You probably got all this from fucking Chi-Chi.
Gohan, never speak of your feelings. You don't want to hurt the burden with your emotions.
Die, okay, mother. Me and my biggest stickus will do it.
Fuck you, Gohan. She's not a child, she's a grown woman! Treat her like that! He thought more of his father. Being excessive much? He was the problem behind all this. How, Gohan? How was he the problem? Did he send the garbage truck her way? Did he tell Chi-Chi to fly that way? You know, What if Chi-Chi decided to meet Goku at Mount Paozu? Nothing would have happened. You wouldn't have had this burden. You wouldn't have had this problem. But she did go there. She went somewhere else. But if she didn't, things would have been different. So, what would you have done if Videl went to, say, Mount Paozu, North City, anywhere, and met Goku, and they arranged all this? What were you going to do? No, wait. Don't answer that, go on. I know what you're going to say. I know who would you blame if Videl never got into that accident. You would have been mad at her. You would have ranted and raved and said every insulting goddamn thing about her. Because she dared to have her own life and own emotions. So don't even try to say anything, Gohan. You make me sick! Why is he up to mess everything up?
Hey guys, and Whiner, you'll never believe who's here.
Hey everybody, and Whiner, a voice called from the side. It was the last voice Gohan wanted to hear. He swung his head around to see Goku surrounded by their family and friends. Seriously changed outside his parents' house. Videl was no longer in front of him, or anywhere else in sight. His group of friends were focusing all their attention on the Saiyan. Goku, you're back. We've missed you so much. Tell us about your adventures. Yay. Once again, nobody was questioning the fire's absence. All that mattered was he was back.
I wonder how Gohan feels about soldiers. I really do.
Oh, hey, guys. Goku chuckled, scratching the back of his head. Yeah, I just came back for Chi-Chi's cooking. Dad got run off again.
Hey, Gohan, did you miss the part where they also pointed out Goku was improving? Or were you so enraged, so focused on all that you chose to ignore it because it ruined your perfect little hatred?
I bet you did.
People like you always do that.
Hey, Whiner shouted, causing everyone to halt their conversations. Oh, hey, loser. Didn't see you there, Goku spoke, still chuckling.
Did you know that Videl is dead because of you? She died for the injury she suffered from the car accident. The one she was in just after she met you. After I told you to stay away from us.
How? How was he responsible? How was he ever responsible?
That same accident you could have protected her from, had you been paying attention!
Technically, so could have you. Gohan, have you ever considered that this is all your fault, too? No. Because you're paranoid! And paranoid people like you tend to blame everyone else but yourself for this! It's like, how? Does a simple meaning?
I told you to stay away from us. The same accident you could have protected her from.
No, he couldn't have. Who could have seen that coming? So wouldn't you be blaming the garbage truck guys for, you know, being blinded and not flying above the clouds or flying below the streets or flying to the left, flying to the right? How? You're blaming Goku with no evidence. Just to fill your own depression and paranoia. You are so controlling and so focused on Goku that you think he's responsible for everything wrong in your life. This is not healthy. This is not sane, Fick. You're not making Gohan to be this tragic character.
You're turning him into a freaking nutzoid! I have expect him to look at Pan the next time she ever wants to fight and just go...
No.
I have expect him to blame Goku for his impotence.
My dad goes deep.
Or see this guy pop ready to pop out of every single freaking rock! It would just mean to keep him happy. Oh well, we can always listen back with the Dragon Balls. I'm kind of with Goku on this. Yeah. And even so, are the Namekian Dragon Balls there? I mean, you could also change time.
You bastard,
he screamed. But, however, it was all a dream. But he's still a paranoid schizophrenic freak. And of course, this fic, being creative as it is, tries the whole entire fake-out death sequence again! And once again, has Goku being a jerk, even though we see him caring. This is the problem, fic. This would have been almost so much easier if Goku had stayed out of the fic. But we see him trying to improve. We see him trying to help. We see him caring! Goku is trying his best to fix things and be good about it. And Gohan is so focused on being angry and being hateful that he's willing to blame anything on Goku if it'll just make him feel better. This is not a healthy relationship. This is very sickening. Because the next thing you know, Gohan's going to go overboard being protective of his family. He's going to go overboard being this, I'm protecting you. And chances are, he's going to accidentally become an abusive asshole. This is not a good character. People, this is not a good mood to be in. This is somebody who is on a very, very self-destructive path. And really, really needs some therapy. And I'm still wondering, how was Goku supposed to do anything? How was Goku supposed to know? I think what happened was the author discovered that he was giving Goku way too many good points and was making Gohan come out like an asshole. So he tried to set this up, but it still doesn't work. Because again, we have seen Goku being caring in this fic and trying to improve. But there was that scene where he was far away from the villains and wasn't being able to be communicated with. Which, again, I pointed out that is an ass pull of the highest degree. Because there should be a way to communicate wirelessly, like, oh, I don't know, cellular phones! After Goku says goodbye and wanting to train, it brought out the absolute worst feelings to him. He found himself reliving every horrific moment from his childhood, from being kidnapped by rats to watching his many friends die. Before everything came flying back to him with one tremendous wave. As everything seemed to be moving, the only moments that were prolonged were the most traumatic ones, the ones that affected him the most. Not a coincidence, they all involved Goku. Oh, you mean like nearly getting his neck broken by... Like getting his neck broken by Raccoon, getting almost vaporized by Nappa, having to watch his mentor almost die once and then die beforehand, having to watch one of his best friends go boom, having to face off against the Emperor of Evil, and it's just all the seeds of Goku not wanting to come back, isn't it? We wish for Son Goku to be brought back to Earth's check-in station. How am I not freaking surprised! Okay, Gohan, you mean to tell me that Goku, choosing to somehow not wanting to let the dragon bring him back, I still don't know how that works, is more traumatic than you almost dying?! Yeah, remind you, your neck was snapped. You were this close to death. You were staring at Frieza at this point. And he killed that little boy. He blew up Krillin. And you're telling me that this one moment, this scene right here, of Goku not wanting to come back, is more traumatic than your eventual death? Well, hey. At least by now, at least you do have one traumatic scene when Goku leaves. But why do I have a feeling that was just throwing me a bone just to make sure that I actually had something here that I could consider traumatic? The demons of his past would not let him go. He felt he was at their mercy. As he dwelled on this, something in him started to reject the notion of comfortability. No, he said out loud, setting up, he wiped the tears from his eyes. Before, he was such a child with no way to confront his demons. You know, other than being a Super Saiyan, there's nothing he could do about it. But now things were different. He had matured into a man. You are not a man! You... The Gohan of this fic is not a man. He's a paranoid, delusional, overprotective child! Who, instead of taking responsibility for any of his actions, chooses to put them on a figure just to make it easier. And then, when he's confronted with the truth, he backs away and cries. Whines and whines and whines in hopes that somebody out there is going to listen. Well, I'm sorry, Gohan.
But I'm not listening.